I'm gonna tell you the truth. You're gonna be attacked, betrayed, exposed, and humiliated. Life is going to break you, and it's going to see how bad you really want it. That's the moment when you are truly alone. And what will you do then? Can you summon the will to fight on through all the pain and rise again? Who are you? That will be the defining question of your life. And I think you already know the answer. Because your pain is your power. You suffer so you can be much stronger.
I don't know what that dream is that you have. I don't care how far-fetched it might appear to be. I don't care how disappointing it might have been as you've been working toward that dream. But here's what I know. That dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible.
Albert Einstein said, imagination is everything. It's a preview to life's coming attractions. Everything you imagine is a preview to a coming attraction. Once you understand that and quit looking at your imagination as hocus pocus, it opens up a wide range of things and possibilities. And if you're bold enough, if you're strong enough, if you can handle the pain, you can make it happen. You just can't quit in the middle of the journey.
In every project, there's escape hatches. And if you don't bolt them closed when the going gets tough, boom, away you go. When you make up your mind to do something, quitting should never be an option. If you're going to quit, quit when you're at your peak, when you're very, very successful. But don't quit because you're tired of paying the price. If you pay the price, the reward is going to be that much sweeter.
I can accept failure. Everyone fails at some point, but I cannot accept not trying. When you've tried your best, when you've given 120%, you should never feel bad. You pick yourself up, you look at it from another perspective, you come up with another solution, and you go at it again. You're a problem solver. You're not soft. You're not weak. You don't quit. You don't surrender. You fall 7 times, you get up 8. You chase after that thing you believe you deserve until you get it. And you let nothing stand in your way. You can't ever feel bad when you put forth 120%. You can't let the outcomes make you feel whack. You're not whack. You're a warrior. You won't always win, but you gotta always try.
Absolutely refuse to quit when you know what you're doing, what you're studying, the price you're paying is going to pay enormous dividends in the long run.
You gotta learn the seed of good and everything that could be negative. And sometimes tragedy strike not to hurt you, but to elevate you in a way. If the tragedy never happened, you would never be elevated.
So you gotta say to yourself, I will learn to see the good in everything bad that happens in my life. These challenges, these tribulations, these things will make me stronger.
With every decision comes a result. With every decision there comes an outcome. And so in order for you to make your dreams and goals become a reality, you gotta be a great decision maker.
It's one thing to talk about your dreams, but it's another thing to wake up when you know you're supposed to wake up. To try again when you failed for the 100th time. To say no to quitting when your body is screaming that you stop. Those decisions, they are the path to your dream.
There will be nobody in this world that will stop you from becoming what you want to become except you. If you walk out of this room today, you owe you to make good decisions. Because when you make bad decisions, you destroy you. You're killing you. You're destroying you. And I told you that if you make good decisions, you reap the benefits of it.
Many of us feel like right now there's a mountain in front of you that seems immovable. But I'm telling you, the power of good choices, the power of hard work, tenacity, refusing to quit, refusing to say I can't and I give up and I quit, but beginning to say and to really believe I can, I must, I will, I refuse, I won't be defeated. Nothing in front of me is going to stop because I can control me. I can control the controllable, and that's how hard I work. That's my desire to refuse to quit no matter what. I will not give up until I achieve my dream.
To anyone out there that's listening, that's started to go down in that hole, trapped in the chains of depression or addiction or rage,
you're going through a tough time. Maybe you're walking through real depression. Maybe you are in a valley today that you've experienced the worst failure of your life and you are on the verge of giving up. Maybe you're here today and your marriage is on the rocks. Maybe you're here today and you're dealing with anxiety on a daily basis.
You know what it's like to be in a lonely, dark place. You know what it's like to want to quit. You know what it's like when the pressure's overwhelming, when people expect your best, but you're at your worst.
That is a moment of choice. That is a moment of decision.
What will your response be? Are you going to sit back or are you going to step up? Adversity creates the perfect moment for audacity. It's in your adversity. The thing that comes out of you is what defines you. When life is squeezing you and pressure is on you, what's really inside of you? See, there's some people in this room right now that you need to hear this loud and clear. You need to get this in your spirit, because I don't know what you're walking through, but some of you right now, you are in a tough season. An event has happened and something's happened and maybe you have failed. But I want to remind you that failure is not final, it's formative. It is part of the process. It's part of the journey. Your failure matters as much as your success. How do you think you're going to grow if you don't ever fail? Yet some of you have failed and you have decided, well, guess what? I'm a failure. No, failure is an event. It is never a person. Just because you failed doesn't mean that you're a failure. In fact, failure is actually fuel for your future, the way that you grow, the way that you advance. You have to fail in order to succeed. The darker the night, the brighter the morning. This too shall pass. You're going to get through this thing. You might not be in control of the storm, but you can have the courage to face the storm, to say, I'm not gonna back down, I'm not gonna run away, I'm gonna walk through this thing, because I believe this thing is leading me to another miracle.
You see, the fight's not over if you've been knocked down. It's only over if you quit. If you make the decision to get up one more time, I'm telling you, you will win the fight.
None of us ever get through this life without heartache, without turmoil.
We're all going to fail at something. Everyone's failed at something.
Life is a trial. And trials are never supposed to be easy.
Life is hard. It's hard handling the tragedies of life. When you're working on something and you put everything you have in it, and it doesn't work out, you lose your money and other people's money. It's hard.
It is okay to be scared. It is okay to cry. But giving up should not be an option.
And it doesn't matter how you get knocked down in life, because that's gonna happen. All that matters is that you gotta get up.
Because when you fail, you get up, and then you fail, and then you get up, and that keeps you going. That's how humans are strong. Failure is an option, but giving up is not.
Find a way. If you believe and you have faith, and you can get knocked down and get back up again, and you believe in perseverance as a great human quality, you find your way.
You gotta have that resiliency over and over again.
You gotta make a commitment to keep stepping up to the plate and swinging for the fences. Every day, whenever you do what you do, swing for the fences. Understanding when you swing for the fences, sometimes you'll miss. Did you know Hank Aaron had twice as many strikeouts as he had home runs? But he kept swinging for the fences. Most times he missed, but when he hit it, he knocked it out the park. When it's your shot to do what you do, keep swinging and keep striving. Change is gonna happen in your life. Setback's gonna happen. But a setback is nothing but a setup for comeback.
The champions, it's not their potential, it's not their genetics. It's their perseverance to always show up, always willing to fail, because in failure, that's part of success. Success is not a marathon of life with just ups. Success is formulated through failures, through facing your fears, through falling down and getting back up. That's what creates the champion.
Did you know that less than 1% of people
are naturally extraordinarily gifted at something. Think genius, think savant. Do you know what that means for us, the other 99%+ of people? If we're going to do anything great in this life, it is going to require discipline. That's the truth. If you are going to accomplish anything extraordinary with the days on this planet, it is going to require you pushing through the discomfort and embracing the grind and disciplining yourself.
If you want to live your best life, your absolutely best life, you got to do me a huge favor. You got to watch them choices you make. People make bad choices. They wake up another, make another bad choice. They make another bad choice. Now they got a habit of bad choices. And they like, how did I get here? Choices. How did I get here? You trying to get to certain places, but you ain't making the choices that's going to get you there. You all in your feelings.
The cause of laziness is a craving for comfort. It's wanting comfort. Ultimately, your problem is not laziness. It's the worship of comfort which produces laziness. It's that I don't want to do anything that I don't want to do. It's believing this lie that if it doesn't come completely natural to me, if it's not easy, then I shouldn't have to do it, or maybe I'm doing the wrong thing.
You have to make a choice. Either you're going to resort back to your old place and remain comfortable and miss the opportunity, or you're going to have to want it bad enough to get out of your comfort zone.
You can lie to yourself and then you don't need discipline. You can tell yourself everything's okay and then you don't need discipline. You can tell yourself, you can lie to yourself and say that you're winning and then you don't need discipline. But if you tell yourself the truth, if you tell yourself the truth that you know you could be better, you know you could do more, if you tell yourself the truth, you won't have to find discipline. Discipline will find you.
The greatest version of you is not the I can do anything version of you. The greatest version of you is the disciplined version of you. The greatest version of you is the version that has parameters. No, I don't do that. I don't drink that. I don't go there with these people. I'm focused. I have a prize that's in front of me. I know what I'm supposed to do, and that ain't it. I have to stay right here.
You can become godly through discipline. Not easy, not just because you feel like it, that sometimes you have to honor the grind.
If it don't scare me, I don't want to do it. If it ain't edgy and half crazy, I'm not interested in it. But if it's something I can't pull off by myself, and I gotta stay up at night, I gotta pray my way through it, then I'm ready to do it.
Because nothing great comes without struggle.
Excellence requires discomfort.
There's got to be some type of discipline attached to whatever you want deliverance in.
And what I'm telling you is the battle never changes. Every day, you have to get self-control.
You will have to think and find creative ways to make the next move happen. Your next move is in between your ears. When your head shifts, your life is going to shift.
You've got to begin to think about the things you want to materialize in your life on a regular basis and think about it repetitiously. Literally, the things that we obsess about become the things that we possess in our lives. Your mind is a weapon, and you got to begin to use it and pick that weapon up and control it. Most people are out of control with their mind. They don't point it at something. They let the world point it, and they misfire all the time. So today, I want you to pick up that weapon that is your mind and begin to point it at the things you want.
Becoming successful is a situation of developing discipline, persistence, patience, grit, character traits that you don't just get. You are not fucking born with. It's going to come down to you developing the ability to do the things that you don't feel like doing because you know that it's the right thing to fucking do.
So often, we want to blame circumstances for the way things are. We want to blame genetics for the reason we're kind of fat. We got all these problems. But might I suggest,
the problem is the pattern of your response.
But you can't change the product if you don't change the pattern. You can't change the way your career's going if you don't start changing your work ethic and your work habits and your inner relations. You can't change your wisdom unless you change your input. Because the problem is the pattern.
Whatever's going on is your fault. It is your fault. Accept that, own it, and then deal with it.
Every decision that you make has consequences. Are you making yourself better? Are you making yourself worse? Are you moving forward or are you moving back? Are you making progress or are you stagnating? Every little decision you make counts.
And most people will not be successful. They will not reach whatever they wrote because when there's not anything emotionally attached to it, they're gonna quit and give up. Most people were closer than they ever thought they were to finishing that big thing, but they never finished it because they didn't feel like finishing it. Or they were doing it and it was pain. And most people quit in the pain because the pain hurts so bad that they don't know if they wanna keep going to get to go. Because you're gonna wake up most days and not feel like it. You're gonna wake up most days and not be pumped up. You're gonna wake up most days and not feel like doing it. But when you can get to a point that you do it anyway, then there's no way you won't reach any of your goals.
You are not where you want to be, not because you need any more gifts. You don't need nothing else. You need to discipline yourself. You need to learn to tell you no. You keep talking about everybody else you can't tell no. You can't tell you no. You can't tell you stop. You can't tell you quit. You got to get to a point where you're disciplined.
It's a muscle. The mind is a muscle. Emotion is a muscle. I don't negotiate with myself. Well, maybe I'll do it tomorrow. I'm going to do this. Or I'll let me wait 2 more minutes till I'm ready. There's none of that shit with me. For decades, I go, I say, we do. I'm not here to discuss this shit with my mind. There's mind, and then there's soul and spirit. And soul and spirit, my soul fucking knows. And when I say jump, you fucking jump. I'm not here to have a discussion with you.
But you have to take control and train this brain. If you don't train this brain, it'll use you instead of you using it.
Everyone wants some life hack that eliminates the need to do the work, but that does not exist. You have to do the work. You've got to hold the line. You've got to make it happen.
What could you be if you worked as hard as you could? What could you be if you imposed real discipline in your life? I said you crank up the volume on that question. Max it out.
And then go get some.
People who win f***ing douche and people who lose talk sh**. You can win if you choose to learn the things that you need to do and then f***ing do them. That's reality. That's the sh** nobody wants to admit, because admitting so means that you have to take responsibility for where you are currently. And you have to say, I am where I am currently because I didn't do X, Y, and Z. And guess what? That f***ing hurts a little bit. But once you accept that truth, you are able to then move forward with the actions required to get you to where you want to go.
You have no business being average, but now you justified it. You come up with these great reasons why you can't get up at 5. You have these great reasons why you have to do everything, why you don't execute, why you don't finish, why you don't follow through, why you say you'll exercise and you do it for about 10 days and you quit. You've got an excuse for why you're average. I guarantee you, if you were humble enough, if you were hungry enough, if you really wanted what you said, you'd sit down and you'd study what you do and you'd say, I can do this better. But I have not exhausted all my time. I have not exhausted all my resources. There's something missing. You're not where you're supposed to be. It's not going to take a lot, but it's a small gap. And the gap is called execution. If you want to execute just a little bit more, you'll be on a whole other level.
You have to master the monotonous. It's the boring sh. It's the everyday sh. It's the regular sh. It means doing the sh that most people are too fucking undisciplined to do day in and day out with perfection. Doing it better than everybody else. Doing it to the best of your ability. You have to remind yourself that these little things that you do are going to lead to the big things. Are you going to do your workout or are you not? Are you going to do your cardio or are you not?
You think things are going to just go your way? Well, they're not going to just go your way. You got to make them go your way. You think things are going to just happen for you? Well, they're not just going to happen for you. You got to make them happen.
Discipline your body. Free your mind. Get up early and go.
get after it, and you'll become the person you want to be. And you become that person through one small decision at a time.
You might be smarter. Your family might come from privilege. Your daddy might own a company, but you will not outwork me.
This top spot, this number one, that's mine. Because not one of you can outwill me. You may have been born with more genetic prowess than I have, but you cannot outdetermine me. You can't outwill me. You can't outwant me. You can't outwork me. You can't outdesire me. The bigger